Hello, Aries. Welcome to another love reading. This love reading will be all about your person, the person that you're currently thinking about or connecting with at this time. Keep in mind, these readings are general, so take what resonates for you, what applies to you. We're going to be looking at your person's thoughts, feelings towards you, and their intentions for the near future when it comes to you or this connection. So let's jump right in. Spirits, angels, guides, what messages, guidance you have for Aries regarding love. What's going on for Aries and love? This reading will be for those of you that are already in some sort of a connection or have someone in mind. What's going on in this connection between Aries and their person? What's going on in this connection? Ten of Cups. Nice. What's going on in this connection? Queen of Wands, Page of Wands. Interesting. Communication. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy with the Queen of Wands. There you are. And the Ten of Cups. So what I'm getting is like this communication, this exchange, I feel is going to make you very happy, Aries. Tell me about the Page of Wands. Tell me about the Page of Wands. Wow, the Wheel of Fortune. Tell me about the Page of Wands. So this will be a message, an exchange that causes some sort of movement, forward movement, a huge opportunity. Yeah, the world. Complete change in this connection. Knight of Cups at the bottom of the deck. So interesting. So I feel like there's going to be some sort of change in this connection, Aries, that's going to make you very happy. That's going to almost like open a door here, especially with this beautiful design here on this vice versa deck. See how it's like almost like a door opening. And it's going to make you very happy, very fulfilled. It's going to be something that perhaps you've been waiting for. Tell me about the Queen of Wands. Why is the Queen of Wands here? Nine of Cups. Yeah. There's a Queen of Swords. Yeah, this is what you wanted. You wanted to hear from this person. You wanted to get this message, this communication from this person. Page of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Definitely. Very interesting. And very like to the point too. Can I get one more for this Queen of Swords? Five of Pentacles and the High Priestess. Okay, so I feel like you wanted clarity. You wanted to know something here. You were maybe out in the cold or feeling lost or like something was missing here. You were missing information, needing certain information, needing some sort of truth or message to come in. Yeah, I feel like you've been waiting for a while here. So I have the Nine of Wands at the top. I had the Hangman that was kind of coming out of the deck here. So I feel like you were kind of waiting here. Bottom of the deck, Four of Wands. The Strength card, Leo energy. The Lovers after that, Gemini energy. Yeah, like you were being strong. But you, this is probably like a twin flame or soulmate connection. Strong, patient, and waiting for this to just unfold. Very, very nice energy. So let's look at how you're feeling or thinking about each other. Oops. Spirits, angels, guides, clarity, please, regarding Aries and this other person. Aries, I'm going to have you on one side, your person on the other, but you can flip it if it resonates more for you. Tell me about Aries. Tell me about Aries and the energy they bring to this connection. Tell me about Aries. What's Aries thinking or feeling? We have known each other before. Tell me about the person that Aries is dealing with. Sir, what are their energies towards Aries? I regret not taking action sooner. So you have been kind of waiting. That's kind of the energy I'm picking up here. Tell me more about Aries and this other person. Tell me more about Aries. Tell me more about Aries. Moving forward, movement, ending cycles. You're moving forward into a new chapter. Tell me about the person that Aries is dealing with. What are their energies, Spirit? Sweet dreams, fantasy, dreams, imagination. Your dreams are becoming reality. Tell me more about this person that Aries is dealing with. Tell me more. Tell me more about this person. Falling leaves. Time changes everything. Changes, transition, time. Time has passed here. Bottom of the deck, deep regret. And this person has regrets, I feel, over the time. I regret not taking action sooner. Not sure what happened, but I feel like this is somebody who perhaps wishes that they had things had gone differently. But time has passed between you and this person being together, I feel. Tell me more. Tell me more for Aries. Tell me more for Aries, please, Spirit. Can you tell me about Aries? Can you tell me about Aries? The Panther. Wow. So moving forward, and the Panther is kind of like the Tower card. You've gone through maybe some transitions, some changes. Maybe this is like inwardly you've gone through some changes, or maybe you've gone through difficult cycles as you've waited for this person. Maybe there have been difficulties that you're experiencing right now. I feel like there's some sort of, like, this tower is almost making me think of the Wheel of Fortune, like especially with moving forward, because there's movement forward. Remember when I put down that Wheel of Fortune card, I set that. And so these two cards together are making me think of that Wheel of Fortune. Tell me about Aries person. Tell me about the person that Aries is dealing with. What are their energies? The Beaver. Oh, every time I see the Beaver. And the Bee. Okay, so this is someone that's focused, working, busy. The Beaver is very family oriented. They're providers, hard workers. All they care about is having their family be provided for. And there's the Elk, which is kind of like the King of Pentacles energy. The Beaver to me is kind of like a baby King of Pentacles. So very interesting that I have both of these energies. Interesting. So this person has been working hard, is focused, and I feel like they, especially because I have sweet dreams here, your dreams are becoming reality. It's like they're trying to make something happen here, and it has something to do with you. Let's put these up there. Let's get some insight into how you feel towards each other here. And again, Aries, I'm gonna have you on one side, your person on the other, but feel free to flip the energies. Tell me more about Aries and their person. Tell me more about Aries and their person. Oops. Okay. I don't know what's going on with my deck. Are you seeing this? What is going on with my deck? It's a small enough deck. I mean, it's not like my hands cannot handle this deck, but anyways, okay, not sure what happened there. Okay, Spirit, tell me more about Aries. What is Aries thinking or feeling when it comes to this connection or this person? Six of Swords, moving forward. Seven of Pentacles, tell me more about Aries. The Star, Aquarius energy. So I feel, oh, there's a Knight of Cups. I feel like you are going through, or there's going to be some change that's going to happen here. There's healing. There's a wish, a desire here, especially with the Nine of Cups, Seven of Swords behind that. Why the Six of Swords? It's almost like there's movement here. Like you're moving towards something. But what? Why is the Six of Swords here? Spirit, why is the Six of Swords here? The Ace of Cups? Yeah, Aries, you're moving towards something abundant, something that's very beautiful. The Ace of Cups is almost like an opportunity that's very emotionally fulfilling. Yeah, there's some sort of cycle you're entering into where there's new love or an opportunity for something very loving, very fulfilling for you. Tell me about the Seven of Pentacles. Again, I see you waiting, especially in this deck. Nine of Swords there. See this person? They're like almost like waiting to see something. Waiting for something to happen. Tell me about the Seven of Pentacles. Spirit, why is the Seven of Pentacles here for Aries? Death, Scorpio energy. That's that Panther card. This is all kind of working like they're. I'm basically getting confirmation off of the energies that I've already pulled for you. And bottom of the deck, I have the Nine of Cups again. So whatever change, transformation, ending that has happened, it's going to be giving you an opportunity that you've wished for. I don't know if this is an ending that you're experiencing or an ending that your person's experiencing that has to do with you, but it's going to bring about something that you desired. Tell me about this Seven of Pentacles. Can I get one more? Can I get one more for this Seven of Pentacles, please? Judgment, number 20. Another major arcana here. A second chance, a revival, a resurrection. Aries, there's something coming here that's, I feel, going to be loud. It's going to be something that happens that I feel completely starts you in a new cycle because we have death and then judgment. After judgment comes the world. We have the Ace of Cups, which is about a new beginning. It's an ace, so it's the beginning of something, which the world leads to the Fool. So I feel like this is all connected. Can I get one more for the Death card and the Judgment card? And in this deck in particular, this reminds me of the Lovers. Two naked people, also some child in the midst here. Hold on. Don't know what's going on with my deck today. King of Cups fell. Tell me about death and judgment. Tell me about death and judgment, Spirit. Why is death and judgment here? The Tower. You see what I'm saying? This is all connected. There's a big change happening here, Aries. And it's related to this other person or this particular connection. This could even be something that you're going through on your own, but it's still leading you somewhere new. There's the Fool. Wow, this is crazy. This is a crazy reading. Tell me about the Star. Healing, renewal. Faith, hope. Why is the Star here for Aries? Why is the Star here? The High Priestess. Look at all this major arcana. Tell me about the Star. Something intuitive, a change that's occurring here, a healing that's happening, that's a spiritual healing. This could be as well. Tell me about the Star. Tell me about the Star. The Empress. You gotta be freaking kidding me right now. The Nine of Cups at the bottom of the deck again. What is happening, Aries? What is happening? This is crazy to me. And once again, a progression. High Priestess is number two. The Empress is number three. I just keep seeing progressions here. After the Tower comes the Star. Tower's number 16, the Star's number 17. We have six, number six that goes into a seven. We have one, two, three. I just keep seeing progressions here. We have here the Death card is number 13th and 20. It's the only ones that are kind of like, out of the sync of things. But even death and judgment, like these two cards bring about a complete transformation. They're transformative energies, you know? Death is something that is that leads to a new beginning. That's it's a rebirth, you know, the death card. And judgment leads to the world, which is a whole new beginning. So you see what I'm saying here? Okay, let me move on. Whatever this is, it's going to set you up to something that's very abundant. And I feel like this might have been a secret desire of yours, Aries. Tell me about this person that Aries is dealing with. Tell me about this person that Aries is dealing with, Spirit. What do we need to know about this other person? When it comes to Aries, when it comes to this connection, what are this person's energies? We have the Chariot, Cancer energy. Tell me more about this person that Aries is dealing with, Spirit. Tell me more about this person. We have Justice. Yep. Justice. Have these three cards, Three of Cups, Three of Pentacles. I'm seeing like a reunion. This card's making me think of the Star card, actually, this Three of Cups. Just gonna flip this over so I don't get confused. Tell me more. Tell me more about this person's energies. One more, please, Spirit. Can we get some insight into what this person is thinking or feeling when it comes to Aries or this connection? Okay, I got two. The Emperor. Aries energy. There you are. All three major arcanas here with the King of Swords. Wow. Two big swords. The Chariot, movement forward, coming forward, a direction that leads to success. Action, you know, the chair, you know, I feel like both of you are kind of mirroring each other there. Justice is a card about things that are fair, balanced, objective, a final decision of some sort. Justice making something right that wasn't right before. The Emperor, especially the Emperor and the Chariot, these are almost like doing action energies. So let's get some insight here. Just saw the Fool again. The Two of Cups is there. Okay. Tell me about the Chariot. Tell me about the Chariot, please. Queen of Swords. So this is somebody that's coming forward to clear the air, to have some sort of honest discussion. Another big sword there. So I feel like there's clarity, truth, victory. Tell me about justice. Libra energy, we're here with justice. Nine of Pentacles. Tell me about justice. Ooh, somebody could be free of a legal situation or an official situation. Or I'm also getting like with this card, like something's made right so that someone is able to have security and independence. King of Cups, there's a Two of Cups at the top of the deck. Bottom of the deck, Seven of Swords, Seven of Cups, and the Magician. This is someone that's, especially with all these cards, the Magician and the Seven of Swords, I think of someone that is strategizing, planning. They're gonna go about something in whatever way they can. And the Seven of Cups is here almost as if to say, what is the best course of action here? Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy there. So I feel like whatever decision this is an emotional security, emotional stability, independence here with the Nine of Pentacles and the King of Cups. But it happened because of justice, because something was made right. Tell me more about justice. Again, I don't know if this is someone that was in a legal situation or if an official decision was made here. Eight of Cups. This person could have walked away from something. Again, being on a journey of some sort, Eight of Cups and the Chariot, you have the Six of Swords. It's like you're both like guided towards each other here. So this person, I feel like justice helped them free themselves or walk away from something in order to have more security, independence, and stability. Tell me about the Emperor here with the King of Swords. What about the Emperor here with the King of Swords? This is somebody that's definitely going to talk to you, or at least come forward with a message. There's the Fool. You both got the Fool here. A risk, a leap of faith, a new beginning. Again, freedom. Nine of Pentacles and the Fool. These are people that are free of baggage, free of things that are holding them back. They don't need anybody else, really. They're on this journey on their own, kind of. Tell me about the Emperor and the King of Swords. The Eight of Swords. Yeah, there's freedom from somewhere that they were stuck. It's very, like, interesting here. There could be somebody that's taking a risk despite fear as well. Tell me more about the Emperor. Especially the Emperor. He gets things done. He takes action. He is very decisive. Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, this is somebody that's on a journey that might not be the quickest journey, but they'll eventually have success here with the Knight of Pentacles. Maybe they will... sorry, my phone is telling me I have low battery. Maybe they will make an offer of some sort at the end of the day, you know, even though it might take them some time. Actually, let me just ask. Spirit, tell me, what are this person's intentions or next actions towards Aries? What are this person's true intentions or next actions towards Aries? What are their true intentions or next actions towards Aries, Spirit? Eight of Wands. So yeah, communication, action, movement. What are this person's true intentions or next actions towards Aries? What are their true intentions or next actions? We have the Seven of Cups and the Page of Wands. So yes, I feel like this is somebody who, Ace of Wands at the top of the deck here, Six of Cups at the bottom of the deck. This is somebody coming forward with some sort of a message. Can I get some insight into the Page of Wands, Eight of Wands? Just to see if Spirit has some clarity here. Can you tell me about the Page of Wands, Eight of Wands? Oh my god, this deck. What is happening? Can I get one, please? Oh my god. Tell me about the Page of Wands, Eight of Wands, please. And I'm not even shuffling that quickly. Ten of Cups is here. Tell me about the Page of Wands, Eight of Wands, please, Spirit. Why is the Page of Wands, Eight of Wands here? Page of Cups. This is an emotional, yeah, Page of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck. We have the Sun at the top of the deck,